would like to tell you a story entitled Margaret's Fountain. Margaret looked next to a little fountain. All day and night, sparkling drops danced in the fountain pool. Benjamin lived at the bottom of the steeples nearby. Every day he would watch Margaret dancing around the fountain. He longed to be friends with her, but he was too shy and didn't dare. So Margaret danced alone. One day, someone was dancing with Margaret. His name was Randolph. His coat was dark and glossy, and his eyes were black as oil. He wanted the little fountain for himself. "You are the most beautiful dancer I have ever seen," he told Margaret. "You have a lovely voice." So Margaret danced and sparkled for him, but he was actually lying. One day, Randolph stopped telling Margaret that she was a beautiful dancer.
"You are making me dizzy with all the spinning!"
Dumbled.
"Be quiet! I want to listen to the sound of my fountain."
"Your fountain?"
Margaret gasped. "It's my fountain now! You must find somewhere else to live! The sewers are empty! You can live there!"
So Margaret no longer sparkled or danced. She curled up in the old sewers alone. Benjamin felt sad for Margaret. Then he had an idea. He rolled into the deepest grave. It's dark and scary. Shadows slithered onto all like huge monsters. At last, he found what he was looking for. It was the wheel of the fountain. The next day, the fountain was silent and still. "Work!" ordered Randolph. But nothing happened.
"What is wrong with my fountain?"
Benjamin was standing by the drain. The fountain is missing Margaret. We must bring her back. So Randolph ran to the sewers and dragged poor Margaret out. But the only reason he helped Margaret is because he wanted the little fountain to work. Randolph waited, but still nothing happened.
"You lied to me,"
Randolph said. "The fountain is unhappy because Margaret is unhappy. We must be kind to her." So Randolph helped Margaret clean her coat and straighten up her whiskers. But still the fountain was silent and still.
"You lied to me," Randolph
shouted. The wolf was angry. Benjamin felt scared. His little tail was shaking. Margaret couldn't bear to see Randolph scaring him. "There's a little wheel in the deepest drain. It turns the fountain on, but the drain is too dangerous." Randolph laughed.
"Ha ha ha! I'm not scared of anything!"
So he crawled into the drain and disappeared. Later, he slid out onto the ground. He was shaking. He was dirty. Benjamin went into the drain. And later, stepped out of the drain. His eyes were full of fire. He was not scared anymore.
"You are a coward," he said.
"Your heart is stony but as tiny as a single drop of water." Randolph said,
"But this is my fountain."
"No, this is Margaret's fountain. Leave now and leave Margaret alone." So Randolph slowly walked away and disappeared into the dark. Then, something magical happened. The fountain burst into life. The water flew higher and higher. Now everything's back to normal. Margaret still dances around the fountain, but now Benjamin dances with her. I hope you enjoyed listening to my happy ending story. The moral of the story is, we must be kind to each another and must not take things without others' permission. Thank you.